Hello everyone. In lecture 1, we have discussed about simple gate drains, and here we are going to discuss about compound gate drains. And here this is a diagram of compound gate drain. You can observe second and third gears, fourth and fifth gears are fitted on a common shaft. So this is the common shaft for these two gears, and this is the common shaft for these two gears, 4 and 5. But in case of simple gate drain, we have only one shaft that is fitted with one gear. But here, in case of compound gate drains, we'll be having two gears fitted for one shaft. And when a series of gears are connected in such a way that two or more gates rotate about an axis with the same angular velocity. So here you can see he has mentioned some angular velocity. That means as this 2 and 3 gears 2 and 3 fitted on a common shaft, these two will be having same speed. That means if n2 is the speed of the second gear, which will be equal to n3, that is nothing but speed of third gear. In the same manner, if you observe 4 and 5 gears are fitted on a common shaft here, so if n4 is the speed of the fourth gear, that will be equal to n5, which is the speed of fifth gear. Now in simple gate trains, if you want to find out the train value of this compound gate train, we have the relations just like simple gate train. Now let us see. Consider gear 1 and gear 2. So for gears 1 and 2, we have relation, that is N2 by N1 is equal to, we can write T1 by T2. And for gears 3 and 4, why I am taking 3 and 4, why not 2 and 3? See here, 2 and 3 are fitted on a common shaft, right? So that is the reason I am taking 3 and 4. In previous I have taken 1 and 2, now I am taking 3 and 4. Why? Because 3 and 4 in contact at this location. So if we take 3 and 4, then we can write N4 by N3 is equal to T3 by T4. And in the same manner, if you consider 5 and 6 gears, we can have N6 by N5 is equal to T5 by T6. Now multiply these three equations, then we are going to get like this, that is N2 by N1 into N4 by N3 into N6 by N5 is equal to, you can write T1 by T2 into T3 by T4 into T5 by T6. Now we can observe here, already I have written the speed of second and third shafts will be same, and fourth and fifth shafts will be same. So N2 is equal to N3 and N4 is equal to N5. So here you can write, you can cancel here these two terms, N3, N2 and N4, N5. So finally, you are going to get train value, that is N6 by N1 is equal to T1 into T3 into T5 by T2 into T4 into T6. So here T1, T3, T5, these are the number of teeth on first gear, third gear and fifth gear. If you observe 1 and 2 gears, 1 is the driving gear and second one is the driven gear. And if you observe 3 and 4, 3 is the driving gear and 4 is the driven gear. And if you observe 5 and 6, 5 is the driving gear and 6 is the driven gear. Means it is nothing but product of teeth of all driving gears divided by product of teeth of all driven gears. So therefore train value, which is nothing but n6 by n1, you can write product of number of teeth of driving gears, product of number of teeth of driving gears divided by product of number of teeth on driven gear. So this is how we are going to calculate the train value in case of compound gear drive. Next, so now I am going to solve a small problem on compound gear train. Here this is the data given for this. A compound gear train is shown in the figure. Here we can see in the diagram, this is a compound gear train, consists of compound gears BC and DE. So B and C is a compound gear and D and E is a compound gear. All gears are mounted on parallel shafts. So 1, 2, 3, 4, these 4 are parallel shafts. And the motor shaft is rotating at 800 RPM connected to the gear A. That means gear A is having a speed which is equal to NA is equal to 800 RPM. That is given. And the output shaft to the gear F. So here this is the output shaft, this is the input shaft. So for the input shaft we have gear A and for the output shaft we have gear F. And the number of teeth on gears A, B, C, D, E and F are 24, 56, 30, 80, 32 and 72. So here as I already mentioned, 24 for A, B 56, C 30, D 80, E 32 and F 72. Determine the speed of gear F. So here we have to find what is the value of NF in terms of RPM. Now in order to calculate that, we can use the previous formula that we have discussed in compound gear train. Here NF is the output gear and NA is the input gear. So we have a formula, that is train value NF by NA is equal to, so numerator will be the number of teeth of driving gears and denominator will be number of teeth of driven gears. If you observe, A is the driving gear for A and B, C is the driving gear for C and D, and E is the driving gear for E and F. So here driving gears are A, C and E. So I am writing here TA into TC into TE by TB into TD into TF. So that is NF by NA is already given, which is equal to 800. So I am writing here 800 is equal to TA. So the value of TA is 24, I have mentioned here, into what is the value of TC, number of teeth on gear C is 30, into what is TE, number of teeth on gear E 32 by 56, that is the number of teeth on gear B, into number of teeth on gear D is 80, into number of teeth of gear on F. So if you simplify this, so we are going to get the speed of output shaft, that is NF, is equal to 57.5 0.14 rpm. So this is the solution, right? So this is the simple problem I have solved here with respect to compound gate length. Now next one I'm going to discuss reverted gate drain. So this is also a compound gate drain. Reverted gate drain is also a compound gate drain, but how it differs, the simple logic here is this is gear 1, this is gear 2, this is gear 3, and this is gear 4. This is also a compound gate drain. How can I say compound gate drain? You can see second and third gears are fitted on a common shaft, but the difference between compound gate drain and reverter gate drain is here the input shaft, this is the input shaft and this is the output shaft, are coincident. Means these two will coincide. If in a compound gate drain, if the input shaft and output shaft coincide, then such kind of gate drain is called reverted gate drain. And just like compound gate drain, if you want to find out drain value for this reverted gate drain, you can see here drain value is nothing but the formula is N4 by N1. What is N4? The speed of the output shaft by N1 is nothing but speed of the input shaft. So we have N4 by N1 is equal to T1 into T3. What is T1? Number of teeth on input shaft, that is 1. And what is T3? Number of teeth on third gear. Right? So if you consider 1 and 2, T1 becomes the number of teeth on the driving gear. If you consider 3 and 4, this becomes the driving gear. So product of teeth of driving gears divided by product of teeth of driven gears. So N4 by N1 is equal to, I have written T1 into T3 by T2 into T4. Now we have one more relation for this reverter gate drain is if R1, R2, R3 and R4 are the pitch circle radii of gears 1, 2, 3, 4. Then we can write this formula, that is R1 plus R2 is equal to R3 plus R4. What is R1 is? R1 is nothing but pitch circle radius of this first gear. What is R2? Pitch circle radius of second gear. So the distance from here to here will be equal to the distance from here to here. Now what is the distance from here to here? That is nothing but the distance from here to here is R3. R3 is nothing but the radius, pitch circle radius of third gear plus pitch circle radius of fourth gear. So we have relation for reverter gate drain, that is R1 plus R2 is equal to R3 plus R4. So that is how we have a new formula for reverter gate drain.